tried by sinful men, torn and beaten then, nailed to a cross of wood. This the power of the cross. Christ became
God, to whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. God shows his love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. Let us then show our love for him by confessing our sins in penitence. Pray together. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, we have sinned against thee and against our neighbour in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are heartily sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of thy Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve thee in newness of life, to the glory of thy name. Amen. May God, who loved the world so much that he sent his Son to be our Saviour, forgive you your sins and make you holy to serve him in the world, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Most merciful God, who by the death and resurrection of thy Son, Jesus Christ, hast delivered and saved the world, grant that by faith in him who suffered on the cross, we may triumph in the power of his victory. Through Jesus Christ, thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We now listen to our readings from the Old and New Testaments. Barry is our reader this morning.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah. It will not be like the covenant that I made with their ancestors when I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt, a covenant that they broke, though I was their husband, says the Lord. But this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel after those days, says the Lord. I will put my law within them, and I will write it on their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. No longer shall they teach one another or say to each other, "Know the Lord," for they shall all know me, for the least of them to the greatest, says the Lord. For I will forgive their iniquity and remember their sin no more. A reading from the letter to the Hebrews. Christ did not glorify himself in becoming a high priest, but was appointed by the one who said to him, "You are my son, today I have begotten you," as he says also in another place, "You are a priest forever, according to the order of Melchizedek." In the days of his flesh, Jesus offered up prayers and supplication with loud cries and tears to the one who was able to save him from death. And he was heard because of his reverent submission. Although he was a son, he learnt obedience through what he suffered, and having been made perfect, he became the source of eternal salvation for all who obeyed him, having been designated by God a high priest according to the order of Melchizedek. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory. Christ humbled himself and became obedient unto death, even death on a cross. Therefore God has exalted him and given him the name that is above every name. Praise to thee, O Christ, King of eternal glory. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Among those who went up to worship at the festival were some Greeks. They came to Philip, who was from Bethsaida in Galilee, and said to him, "Sir, we wish to see Jesus." Philip went and told Andrew. Then Andrew and Philip went and told Jesus. Jesus answered them, "The hour has come for the Son of Man to be glorified. Very truly I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there will be my servant also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honour. Now my soul is troubled. And what should I say? Father, save me from this hour? No, it is for this reason that I have come to this hour. Father, glorify your name. Then a voice came from heaven. I have glorified it, and I will glorify it again. The crowd standing there heard it and said that it was thunder. Others said, an angel has spoken to him. Jesus answered, this voice has come for your sake, not for mine. Now is the judgment of this world. Now the ruler of this world will be driven out. And I, when I am lifted up from the earth, will draw all people to myself. He said this to indicate the kind of death he was to die. This is the gospel of the Lord. I speak in the name of God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please, would you sit? Sir, we wish to see Jesus. That is the request of the Greeks visiting the festival of Passover in today's Gospel reading. In this sometimes confusing exchange, Jesus tells Andrew and Philip that it is not yet the right time for those, such as the Greeks, who are outside the Jewish community, to meet Jesus as a group. But the hour will come when the message will go out from Jerusalem to the furthest corners of the earth. When Jesus reveals the character of the true God, as he is glorified on the cross, the time for the non-Jewish nations will have arrived. Then the Greeks, and others too, will see Jesus in the ministry of his people. When we picture the people in our congregations and our communities, how many do we imagine have the same heartfelt need and desire as the Greeks to see Jesus, but perhaps feel a little on the outside? And how many simply have not heard or have forgotten the life-changing possibilities of an encounter with him? How should we respond? And if and when people come through these doors over Passiontide, Holy Week, and Easter, what of Jesus will they see? Well, hopefully it is a path they will want to tread, and a place that is welcoming to them. Will it be a life-giving and changing encounter? Like the seed in the earth, there is potential there. When anyone enters this place on Maundy Thursday, will they encounter the humble welcome of the Jesus who wants to wash their feet? If they come on Good Friday, will they encounter the faithfulness of the love of Jesus, whatever the cost? If they come on Holy Saturday, will they encounter the sheer emptiness of life without him? If people come on Easter Sunday, will they encounter a church which knows that Jesus is risen and wants to share the new life and love and light with us all? Sir, we wish to see Jesus, said the Greeks. How can you and I make that happen in the world around us? Amen. Please, would you stand for the Creed? I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Ghost of the Virgin Mary and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried. And the third day he rose again according to the scriptures and ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one holy, Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins. And I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Please, would you be seated? On Ash Wednesday, a cross fashioned from our Christmas tree was placed here in the church. The Christmas tree cross reminds us that Christmas, Lent, Holy Week, and Easter are truly inseparable. The love we see most clearly on the cross is incarnate at Christmas. Bethlehem and Calvary are connected and reveal the God who will go to any lengths for those he loves. On each of the Sundays in Lent, we lay at the foot of the cross objects associated with the suffering of Christ and symbols of our penitence. Today, three nails and a crown of thorns. Jesus, you hung on that fierce cross, tortured within and without. The world you came to save had turned against you, and even heaven itself stayed silent
in the darkest mystery of all. Forgive us when we cause you pain through our words and deeds.
Let us now come before our Lord and God and offer our concerns for the church, the world, and our neighbours in Christ. Lord of the church, as we look towards your passion and death, help us to bring others to know you, so that in knowing you they may love you, and in loving you, they may serve you, for to serve thee is perfect freedom. We pray for the church in Wales and all who will kneel in faith and prayer today. And we ask you to guide and strengthen the mission and the outreach of all thy people. Lord, in thy mercy, we pray for leaders of nations, for rulers of peoples, that they may work with sensitivity and in humility. We pray for nations in the midst of war, especially for Israel, Palestine, Gaza, Yemen, and Ukraine. We pray too for those emerging from tyranny, for freedom movements, and all who work for liberty. Lord, in thy mercy, we remember today all who have been generous to us for their giving of time and attention. We pray for those who have been denied love, for all who have been deprived of well-being. We remember today children taken into care. In our own benefice today, we pray for all those who take responsibility for our parish finances and give thanks for the gifts they bring to that role. Lord, in thy mercy, we give thanks for the passion and the cross of our Lord, for the gift of redemption. We pray for all troubled souls, those who are anxious about their health or their future. We remember those who are being persecuted for their beliefs or principles. And we pray too for all who are suffering at this time, especially for Pam Colley-Priest, Mia Norrington, Jenny Atkins, Christine and Roger Willman, Beth Walton, Pat Curtis, Anne Cole, Gwyneth Coker, Connor McQuarrie, Chris and Ina Hemsley, Joe and David Iggleden, Sarah Walters, and Jonathan Curtis. Lord, in thy mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, give comfort to the bereaved and give courage to the dying. We pray for all who have entered where sorrow and pain are no more. We remember loved ones who have entered into eternal life, especially Valerie Parry, Edna Till, Margaret Miles, and George Newson, who have died recently. And on the anniversary of their death, we pray for Rita Payne, William Juleff, and John Edmonds. Lord, in thy mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus Christ, you were lifted up on the cross for us and our salvation. Help us to triumph over evil and to do good, to give ourselves to you as you give yourself to us, and to live and work for your praise and glory. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of thy Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen.
Would you please stand? Once we were far off, but now in union with Christ Jesus, we have been brought near through the shedding of Christ's blood, for he is our peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you. We pray together. God of mercy and compassion, whose word calls us home to faith and love, accept all we offer thee this day, in the name of Jesus Christ the Lord. Amen. The Lord is here. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God. It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, almighty everlasting God. And now we give thee thanks, because for our salvation he was obedient even to death on the cross. The tree of shame was made the tree of glory, and where life was lost, there life has been restored. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through thy Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. And as we follow his example and obey his command, grant that by the power of thy Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be unto us his body and his blood. Who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread, and when he had given thanks to thee, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks to thee, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me. Wherefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, we remember his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross. We proclaim his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. We look for the coming of his kingdom, and with this bread and this cup, we make the memorial of Christ, thy Son, our Lord. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Accept through him, our great high priest, this our sacrifice of thanks and praise. And as we eat and drink these holy gifts in the presence of thy divine majesty, renew us by thy Holy Spirit, inspire us with thy love, and unite us in the body of thy Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. Amen. Trusting in the compassion of God, as our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break every time we eat this bread and drink this cup. We proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, grant us thy peace. Jesus is the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive thee, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. Lord Jesus Christ, who has taught us that what we do for the least of our brothers and sisters, we do also for thee. Give us the will to be the servant of others, as thou wast the servant of all, who gavest up thy life and didst die for us, yet livest and reignest now and forever. Amen. We pray together. Almighty God, we thank thee for feeding us with the body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer thee our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of thy Spirit to live and work to thy praise and glory. Amen. For the blessing, two very brief announcements. The first is to clarify that the planning application to which we've been referring over the past few days relates to the building of the block of flats, I'm sorry, the two houses in the Vicarage Garden and the one on the Glebe Hall site. It does not relate to the building of the extension. That planning application is due to be in the public domain very soon. If you are minded to support the application to build the houses, which would thus release a huge amount of money which would go towards the financing of the extension, then please do visit the Ashford Borough Council website. There's a link in Connect Up, and all you simply do is click on comments, and I think something simple like "I support this application" would be sufficient. So if you feel minded to support it, please do so. But I just wanted to make clear that that's what the application relates to. That's the first thing to say. The second thing to say is much more important, which is that on Sunday, a week today, we begin Holy Week, Palm Sunday. And for information about all of our Holy Week services, please visit the magazine, Connect Up, look at posters and so on and so forth. And we look forward to journeying with you through that most significant week of the Christian year. And now may Christ crucified draw you to himself, to find in him a sure ground for faith, a firm support for hope, and the assurance of sins forgiven. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Our worship here in church has ended, but our service in the world now begins. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ, Amen.
The power of
to